Looks like this is the last appointment of the day. Hopefully I get done in time for Grandpa's memorial. Wait. This can't be right. The ghost is in a Halloween store? Huh. So it is. Tis the season, I guess. Good afternoon, my name is Carrie. You called me to get rid of a ghost problem you have? Is everything all right? You were expecting someone older? Oh, you talked to my mother. Yes, she was supposed to be here, but she's extra busy with a haunted sorority house. I finished with the poltergeist early, so she asked me to come. Am I capable of handling this? Yes, I've been seeing spirits for as long as I can remember, and I've helped my mother since high school. Believe me, your shop is in good hands. This is a well-stocked store. Costumes, lawn ornament, candy, everything anyone could want. So, where is the place that is most active? The costume aisles? What happens down there? Costumes flying around, bags ripped open and thrown across the floor. You've even had costumes thrown at you? Interesting that this spirit seems to be focused on costumes. When a spirit is focused on a particular item, that usually means there's unfinished business attached to said item. It's just ironic that the item in particular is costumes, given the season. Okay, I'm ready to look into this. I will need you to stay in your office and only come out when I knock 5 times. Thank you. Okay. Salt. In a circle. Candles. Arranged in the salt circle. And... crossing the threshold to the spirit realm, allow me to be your helm. If there is a message to be told, put it before me to behold. I call the spirit before me. I am listening as your trustee. Hello there. Yes, I can see and hear you. I'm a psychic, and I'm here to help you. I cannot help you. Please give me a chance. I may look young, but I have power and experience. Your problem isn't a spiritual one? Then what is it? You need help choosing a costume? Is that why you've been messing up the costume aisles? Oh, you're frustrated. About what? You can't try on the costumes and can't see yourself in the mirror. Interesting. If you don't mind me asking, why are you so focused on this? You were supposed to meet up with your fiancé at a Halloween party before you died? I see. So that's your unfinished business. Well, how about I help you choose a costume? How can I do that? Well, I'll hold up each costume in front of you and give you my honest opinion on it. How will you wear it then? Well, I'll let you in on a little secret. Not even my mother knows this. I know how to make items cross over to the spirit world. Oh, yes. See, I know people sometimes ask to be buried with an item, and as a young child, it got me thinking. How can the spirit enjoy the item if the item is still in the coffin? So, I took it upon myself to learn how to take the item's spirit to the person. Do we have a deal? I'll help you with the costume, and then you'll leave the store alone, all right? Wonderful. Let's get started. So, were you wearing that dress when you passed on? Well, it is very beautiful. You're welcome. Let's see. What would be good for you? Why do most of the costumes lean into the sexy territory? I know, right? Whatever happened to scary costumes or creative ones? I swear. So sexy is out, right? Okay, that leaves nothing in this aisle. Let's check the next one. Oops, wrong turn. This is the kids' aisle. Come on, let's go to the other aisle. Are you all right? Oh, the kids' costumes are making you think about what could have happened? Yeah, it's hard. Can you tell me about your fiancé? Hard-working, dedicated all-American boy? He sounds like such a charming man. You two were high school sweethearts. Oh, that's so sweet. What made you fall for him, besides the charming personality? He had a star-like birthmark on his right temple. Sounds intriguing. What? I said intriguing. It's not every day you hear about such a specific birthmark. So you found yourself curious about it and kept staring at it? Well, it's definitely a conversation starter. You miss him, don't you? Well, let's find you a really good costume then. Who knows? Maybe you'll be in heaven when you cross over. You want to make a good impression when you're reunited, right? All right, let's check this aisle. Well, this half is for men. Unless you want to dress in one of these. Is it allowed? Of course it is. If someone wants to wear a costume, they should. So is that what you want? No? Okay, let's try over here then. Okay, we have good options here. You ready? All right, first one is a clown costume. Yellow is not your color. You didn't like yellow when you were alive? Well, that makes things easy. Here's a superhero one. It's a generic one, so you can make it your own if you want. How do you look in it? You look good, but let's not put all our eggs in one basket. Try a couple more? All right, next is a devil costume. Okay. You don't even want me to even consider that. Very well, it's your costume after all. This black witch dress, you look good in it. Is it potential? Okay, we'll keep it close. This dog outfit, no, it's too bulky, so I wouldn't go with this one. A ninja. This has been done so many times these days, so what do you think? Nope. All right, let's try. What was that? That white outfit in the clearance bin? Sure, we'll check it out. Oh, wow, this is a haunted bride. Are you okay with checking this out? Oh, you really want to try this? You think it's your costume? Stand in front of me so I can see the dress against you. Oh, you look beautiful in this. This will be perfect for you and perfect for the reunion. Okay, stand still and I'll get the dress of spirit to you. This item of joy reminds of a boy. A lost love interrupted, a life disrupted. Take this dress to this soul, allow it to console. Okay, float through me in the dress. So cold, I'll never get used to that. You look beautiful! Yes, I mean it. Oh, he will be starstruck when he sees you. Did I make that pun because of his birthmark? Maybe. All right. Are you ready to move on? Will it hurt? Never. It'll be like falling into a deep sleep after a very long day. Okay. It is time to go, like falling snow. The light awaits, your friends await. Rest now with this vow. The light awaits. It's over. She has moved on. You don't need to thank me. It was actually my honor. Why? That's private. For now, let's discuss fee. Still made good time. I can't believe my luck in meeting her. I hope you're ready to see your first fiancé again, Grandpa.